What's up, guys? Leopold the Brave here, on to Season 3, Episode 6 of The Walking Dead. I almost said Season 2, and I don't know why. But anyways, yeah, it's Season 3. This was a surprisingly super good and jam-packed episode. I was not expecting that at all. So, let's start with the main character, Rick Grimes. He was busy in the room where Lori died, and that fat zombie ate her all up and stuff, I guess. He heard a phone ring, then he answered it, and it was this mysterious voice saying something like they had a safe place and that they were all there or something. I think Rick was just going crazy, because later on it's revealed that it was all the people that have died, like, Dale, Amy, Lori herself. So it was pretty crazy. Either they were calling from heaven, which would be a pretty cool thing. Or Rick was just hallucinating or something. I hope it gets the heaven thing, because it could come into play later. I don't know. I don't know what they could do with that. But it would be neat. And that was pretty much all they had for Rick, but it was pretty hopeful as he finally came to terms with Lori's death and accepted it, and then went back up to see his new daughter, and he's all happy and smiling. But then at the end, he discovers Michonne, who is Michelle or Michonne? I still don't know which one it is. It keeps switching in my head. I'll say Michelle one moment and then Michonne the other. But anyways, she's weak from a bullet wound, I guess. I think she got shot by Merle. It looked like it. And she found the prison somehow. Because she saw Glenn and Maggie get kidnapped, which is super not good. I hope they're okay. That really scares me. They're like my OTP for the show. Glenn and Maggie. They're awesome. And then Daryl, he found Carol, like, hiding somewhere in the prison. I knew she wasn't dead. I just knew it. I had a feeling. So she's all good. She's looking all dehydrated and malnourished, though. So Daryl saved her, and that's awesome. But Andrea is still being terrible. She's flirting with the governor, not seeing anything wrong, just kind of chilling out and just accepting his evilness that I can sense. I can sense there is something not right about him, especially since he had a zombie child or something that he was keeping, and heads in containers. I don't know what his plan exactly is. I mixed those words up. I don't know what his plan is exactly, but I know it is not good. So, overall, this was a really good episode, packed with lots of stuff, and I loved it. My head is theorizing all these different things, and I can't wait to get into the next episode. So I guess I'll see you guys in Season 3, Episode 7. Oh yeah! Season 3, Episode 7. Oh my gosh, that one was so uncomfortable to watch. Oh jeez. So the episode opens up on torture scenes. Glenn and Maggie are being held captive by Merle, who's trying to find where his brother is and everyone else, where they're hiding. I guess so the governor can come take them or something, or steal their prison land. I don't know what they're doing, but wowie zowie. Glenn got beat up real bad by Merle, and then Merle, like, let this walker loose into the room, and Glenn managed to fight it off despite being duct taped to a chair with his arms trapped to the armrest. So that was pretty crazy, that intense scene of him escaping the chair and all that. If only he could escape the room and made it to Maggie, and man, that was stressful. But poor Maggie, she also got tortured too, and ways that I do not want to describe, but it was very uncomfortable to watch, and I did look away many times. Ay, ay, ay. But I'm glad that both of them are okay. Well, hopefully Glenn will be okay. That his face looked pretty bad after all that. That was yikes, and yeah. Oh, I cannot watch that again. But anyways, back with Rick and the group, they found Michonne and sort of took her into the prison, fixed up her bullet wound a bit, and now they're going back out to rescue Glenn and Maggie at this community, so finally the two storylines are starting to combine into one. A bit quicker than I expected, because, I mean, it's only episode 7 out of, like, a 16-episode season. So, yeah. But, Andrea's having issues or something, and I guess the governor's picking up on it. I don't know. Everyone's just really stressing out about different things. But the governor is super awful and rotten, and I don't like him, and hopefully he meets his end soon, or goes away, because, again, I don't like wishing death on people. I mean, yeah, it's a TV show, but whatever. It's still mean. Governor, please go away. You are a bad, mean, rotten person. torturing Glenn and Maggie, and oh my gosh. But overall, there really wasn't much in this episode to talk about. It was just a huge torture episode trying to get Glenn and Maggie to talk, and unfortunately, Maggie is the one that came first because either Merle or the governor, I can't remember, held a gun to Glenn's face. Like, they were aiming right between the eyes, and I honestly thought they were going to pull the trigger if Maggie didn't talk, so oof, oof, oof. But Rick and the others are on their way, so hopefully Glenn and Maggie will be rescued soon. I am stressed out. I don't want anything to happen to those two. Ay. So, on to the next episode. Season 3, Episode 8, Made to Suffer. Woo, this was a really good episode. So basically, the whole thing was basically a rescue mission to get Glenn and Maggie out of Woodbury, or Woodbarrow, or whatever they call this place. Again, I'm bad with names. Even places. Not just people. Even places. But I did get the names of one of the criminals memorized. Axel. The really creepy one with the mustache. But anyways, this is a rescue mission episode for Maggie and Glenn. Michonne helped them invade the town. And they... honestly, I think they got to them pretty easily. It was just getting out that was the problem. But then Daryl got left behind, so they're probably gonna go back after him the next episode. And Andrea's there, and Daryl is reunited with Merle, and they're, like, about to be killed or something. People are chanting to kill them because they think they're terrorists or something. But yeah, it's pretty crazy, but there's a lot of stuff in between all that. Like, for example, Andrea, discovered all the heads in the water, and then Penny and all that. And Michonne killed Penny, even though she was already dead. She basically killed her zombified version, and got rid of one of the governor's eyes. So now he's one eye short. So, that's pretty interesting. Lots of stuff happened. So, everything's gonna blow up big. Like, they're gonna go after revenge, or something's gonna happen with Daryl and Merle. I really don't want Daryl to go. He's the best character, in my opinion. Daryl's so cool. But Glenn and Maggie didn't really do much this episode. They were just kinda being helped escape. Which is okay, they suffered and dealt with enough the last episode, so it's nice they're getting a break, like a free ride out of there, so that's very good. Poor Glenn, though, he can hardly even walk. Yikes. But over back on the prison side, Carl discovered this new little group of people that had managed to find their way into the prison. One of them got bit, so they had to put them down. I don't think they did. I don't think they showed us yet, but maybe they did, I don't know. But yeah, Carl rescued this group, and he's keeping them in a cell, and it's all locked up. One of the chicks, seems a bit unstable about it. Like, she was banging against the bars, saying they can't be kept in there, so it was pretty interesting. She'll probably be the betrayer if, they decide to trust all the rest of them. But that creepy prisoner, Axel, he's sending some bad signals. He's probably gonna go after Carol from some comments he made. Or Beth, again, I think her name is Beth. Names. But yeah, there's a lot of stuff going on, so I can't wait to see the rest of it. Especially the whole Merle thing, because he's pretty much getting kicked out of the town, seen as a betrayer and all that. So, is the group gonna somehow, for some reason, accept him because he was already there before? Or not? Because I think, Glenn and Daryl are, like, the only ones left from that old group, aside from Rick and Carl. I mean, yeah, there's Andrea, too, but she's, like, not with the group currently. But anyways, yeah, can't wait to see the next episode. I'm gonna shut up now. Episode 9. There is pretty much nothing to talk about here. So they did go back to rescue Daryl and Merle, but that was pretty much covered before the... before the intro even began, and the rest of it was just kind of recovering from the whole torture, kidnap, incident, rescue mission. I know we do have a couple recovery episodes here and there, but this was definitely a very bare one. Just people reuniting, talking things out, catching up. But one other big thing did happen. Two other big things, actually. One of them is that Daryl unfortunately left with Merle. I mean, I know we're going to see them again. There's no way that's the last we're going to see of them. I know that for a fact, even though I've never seen the rest of the series. But I just have this huge gut feeling that they're obviously going to come back. I mean, Daryl especially. Merle too. I don't know how they're going to work that out, but yeah. And the other big thing is that Rick's hallucinations seem to be getting a lot worse because they got this new group that I mentioned last time. They have them locked up waiting for Rick to come and give them the A-OK to stay with them. But Rick is just having major trust issues, and he's like, he's seeing Lori where there isn't Lori. He's hearing Lori where there isn't Lori. He just cannot let her go. He just feels so guilty about what happened to her, and it's really heartbreaking, but he's like losing it, dude. So whatever's going on with Rick, I hope he's able to resolve it soon, because I don't think anyone is going to be able to resolve it except for himself, just from how intense these things get and how no one else really understands except maybe Carl. Maybe Carl can get through to him. But yeah, Glenn and Maggie are having some issues too. It's beginning to feel a lot like season 2. Glenn and Maggie stuff. Whatever. I do hope all that gets resolved soon, because I cannot stand any more on again, off again stuff with them. They are a really good pair, and I like both of them as characters, but they cannot keep doing this, please. But Herschel's still being awesome. Carol's upset about Daryl. I think I said that already. I don't remember. Axel is upset about Oscar, I think his name was. I feel bad that I only caught his name now that he's dead. But Oscar went down, so. Andrea seems to be taking the leadership role in the community, though. Just with the hopeful speeches and whatnot. It sounded so fake and sad. Like a government politician speech. It was just woof. More reasons to not be a big fan of her. I'm making myself laugh, and it's probably not making anyone else laugh, so I should probably shut up now and get on to the next episode. You see, there is so little to talk about in this episode that I'm just losing my mind a little. So, next episode. Welp, that happened. Season 3, episode 10. Everything just exploded. So, basically, my theory was right. Wait, did I have the theory? I have no idea. But the theory of Andrea sort of taking the leadership role for the governor, because he had that little meltdown, and now he's gone off to the prison to raid them. Duh. But in between all that, it was actually pretty slow. Still more recovering. Still more Rick wandering around trying to figure things out. And we got to see a bit of Daryl and Merle just exploring the forest. They saved a group of people, helped them along their way when they were being attacked by walkers. And they had a little argument and spat in the forest, and yeah, it seems like Merle had some kind of realization, so maybe he will be joining the group. Maybe I was wrong about that, and also I'm pretty surprised that Daryl just came back this early. I figured it would last at least a couple episodes or something. But they seemed to resolve that thing pretty quick when the jail got raided, so there was a huge shootout scene. It was very butt-clenching and very tense, and yikes. I was sure someone was gonna bite the dust. And someone did. It was that prisoner Axel. He got shot like 50 billion times. But I was thinking one of the like main people was gonna bite the dust there. Like maybe Herschel would get shot, because he was really close. Especially after they let that pack out, that pack of walkers out there. I was also really scared it could have been Carol, because she was hiding behind the dead body of that other guy, of Axel. So I was sure it was gonna be her too. But then again, I was feeling a bit positive, because we did just get her back, and I mean, this show was The Walking Dead, but even I don't think they would kill someone like Carol right after getting her back. Especially with Daryl coming in and, you know, all that good stuff. But yeah, overall, it seems like the prison has been overtaken or, like, reopened to the walkers, so they may have to find a new place to stay. They've got, like, 6 episodes left in this season, so I'm wondering where they'd go from here. Are they gonna retaliate and take over Woodbury? It would be pretty interesting to see with how the people would react and how the people on the governor's side would react to this sort of, you know, crisscross war going on. So that's pretty interesting to think about. I'll be thinking about that until the next episode. But yeah, overall, there was a lot of stuff that happened. It was slow stuff, but a lot of stuff. The big explosion at the end, and I'm very curious to see where we go. But anyways, I think that's it for this set of episodes, and I'll see you guys later.